Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are good. So let us start with chapter number 1 of science, that is plants, the source of food. In this chapter, we will discuss what are the importance or the uses of plants, what is the process of photosynthesis, its definition, what are the things required for it, and how does it actually take place. Then we will discuss the structure of leaf, why are the leaves green in color, and what are the functions of a leaf. After that, we will come down to the role of roots and the role of stem in the plants, particularly in the process of photosynthesis. After that, we will discuss how the food is stored in the plants, and then we will come to discuss what is a starch test and how is it done in the plants. Can you imagine your life without the plants? No, you cannot. Living beings are either plants or they are either animals. We human beings are also types of animals, and we are dependent on the plants for our various uses. We get various products like wood, medicine, rubber, etc. from the plants. They are the main source of food or the primary source of food for the herbivores on the earth. And without the herbivores, the carnivores or the omnivores will also not exist. The omnivores also eat plants, so they are also the main, a very important part of food for the omnivores. Plants give us oxygen to breathe. Without oxygen, you know, we cannot live. And we give back carbon dioxide to the plants by which they breathe and survive. Plants also hold the soil firmly with its root and prevent or reduce the erosion of soil from the running water or the blowing wind. Otherwise, the topsoil will get blown away by the wind or get washed away by the running water, and we will not have fertile soil anymore to live. Plants are also cleaning the air from the carbon dioxide, and they also maintain the temperature of the earth, and they also help in causing the rains, which we will study further. Have you ever thought, how do plants make their own food? They don't have their mothers cooking for them. They make their food in their green leaves. That is why the green leaves of the plants are called the food factories or the kitchens of the plant. Please remember that the leaf has to be green. The leaf cannot be dry and it has to be green in color. Then only it can make its own food. And the things required by the plant to make food are water, and along with that, it also takes minerals, carbon dioxide, which is present in the air, sunlight, which is the main source of heat and light energy coming from the sun, and chlorophyll, which is present in the green leaves. Before we learn about photosynthesis, let us learn about chlorophyll and stomata. Chlorophyll is nothing but a green color pigment present in the leaves, and it helps in trapping the sunlight for photosynthesis. This is the reason why the leaves are green in color. If there will be no chlorophyll, the leaves will not be green in color. Moreover, even if the plants will be kept in the sunlight and they don't have chlorophyll, they will not be able to take in the sunlight and do the process of photosynthesis. The sunlight will only fall on the plant, but it will not enter the plant. The plant will not absorb this sunlight for the process of photosynthesis. Then, let us discuss stomata. The tiny openings, the tiny holes, or the tiny pores on the lower surface of the leaf through which exchange of gases takes place is called stomata. The stomata is usually present on the lower surface of the leaf, but in some cases, like in case of aquatic plants, the stomata can also be present on the upper surface of the leaf. And we all know that plants take in carbon dioxide and give out oxygen gas. This exchange of gases is taking place through the stomata in the leaves. Now let us discuss the process of photosynthesis. The word photosynthesis is made up of two words. First word is photo and the second word is photosynthesis. The word photo means light and synthesis means putting together. So in the process of photosynthesis, the plant is putting together all the products using the sunlight to make its own food. As its definition goes, the process by which, please remember that it is a process. by which the plants make their own food. Who is making their food? The plants. And they are making their own food with the help of carbon dioxide and water, and in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. This process is called photosynthesis. If any one of these things is not present, suppose the carbon dioxide is not present, or the water is not present, or the sunlight is not present, or carbon dioxide, water, sunlight, all three are present, but chlorophyll is not present, then the process of photosynthesis will not take place in the plant. That is why the process of photosynthesis does not take place at night. It takes place only in the daytime when the sun is also present, water is also present, carbon dioxide is also present, and chlorophyll is also present to absorb the sunlight. Let us understand the process of photosynthesis again with the help of this diagram. We all know that the sun is the major source of heat and light in our solar system. This energy which is coming from the sun is being converted by the plants into food. The plants are taking the sunlight from their leaves with the help of chlorophyll. They are taking carbon dioxide through the stomata which is present in the leaves, and they are absorbing the water and minerals present in the soil with the help of their roots. Now, all these things combined together, the plant is converting them into simple sugar called glucose. And along with glucose, plant is also producing a waste gas. It is called a waste gas because the plants have no use of it. And this gas is oxygen. Although it is waste gas for plants, they give it out. It is very important for the animals. So this waste gas, oxygen, which is coming out from the plants, is used by the animals for their process of respiration, process of breathing. So in the process of photosynthesis, the carbon dioxide enters plant through the stomata, which is present on the leaves. Water and minerals are absorbed from the soil by the roots, and sunlight is trapped by the chlorophyll present in the green leaves. And together, all these things are used by the plant to make their own food with the help of the process called photosynthesis. So photosynthesis is the process by which green plants make their own food in their green leaves with the help of carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. And this food is in the process of simple sugar called glucose, and along with glucose, another gas is produced which is called oxygen, which is used by us for breathing and for respiration. Now let us learn about the structure of leaf. The leaf of different plants are different. They can be long like the leaves of the banana. They can be huge like the leaves of a teak, or they can be small like leaves present in roses or the shisham leaves. So leaves are of different types depending on what type of plant it is. But a few parts of the leaf are common, which is the common structure of the leaf that we are going to discuss now. The first part of the leaf is called the petiole or the stalk. The second part is called the main vein or the midrib. The third part is called the leaf blade or the lamina. And the fourth part is called the side vein or just veins. And the side vein is further divided into small nested veins. The first part of the leaf is the stalk or the petiole. This is the part through which the plant is connected with the leaf. The leaf absorbs the water and minerals which are present in the branches of the plant with the help of this petiole. And after the food is being made by the leaf, this, with the help of this petiole, the food is being sent back to the branches of the plant, and through those branches, the food is being then transferred to various parts of the plant for the usage. Next part is the leaf blade or the lamina. This is the flat part of the leaf, and if this flat part would not exist in the leaf, the plants will not be able to absorb the sunlight which is falling on them. The next part is the midrib or the main vein. It is like a center tube which runs through the center of the leaf, and this midrib is further divided into many side veins, and they help to carry the water and minerals to all the small parts of the leaf. And the last part, again we should remember, stomata, which is the tiny holes present on the lower surface of the leaf. which help in the exchange of gases, that is, they take in carbon dioxide and give back the oxygen gas. Now coming to the role of roots in the plant, we all know that the plant is fixed firmly in the soil because the root of the plant is holding the soil very tightly between its roots. So the plant is able to stand erected and not fall, and it is also preventing soil erosion. Another use of roots is that in some plants like radish, carrot, sweet potato, the extra food which is produced by the plant is stored in the roots, and we eat these parts of the root as food. But in the process of photosynthesis, the main part of the roots is to absorb the water and minerals which are present in the soil. This is done with the help of tube-like structures which are present in the roots. Coming to the role of stem in the plant, we all normally would say that this is the part of the plant which is holding the plant upright, or this is the part of the plant on which the other parts of the plant like leaves, buds, flowers and fruits grow. But in the process of photosynthesis, the main job of the stem is to carry the water and minerals absorbed by the root to the leaves. There are tube-like structures present in the stem. You will study about them in the senior classes. They are called xylem and phloem. So with the help of these tube-like structures, transportation or movement of water and mineral is taken place from the roots to the leaves. Till now, we have discussed how the plants make their own food with the process of photosynthesis in their green leaves. Now, let us discuss how this food is being used and stored by the plant. First of all, the plants make their food in the form of simple sugar, and this simple sugar is called glucose. Initially, this food, glucose, is being used by the plant to produce energy for its survival, and then it is being used for the growth and repairing of damaged cells and tissues. Whatever extra food is being left in the plant, it is stored in the various parts of the plant in the form of starch. This food is stored generally in the fruits. We all have seen many types of fruits, mango, banana, apple, you name it and you people know it. Secondly, the food can also be stored in the stem. For example, in the sugarcane or the potato, it can also be stored in the roots, like in sweet potato, carrot, radish. It can be stored in the leaves also. For example, in spinach, cabbage, the animals, including human beings. We human beings eat these stored food of the plant to get the energy. Now, I told you the word starch. Starch is nothing but when the simple sugar which is left by the plant and not being used immediately, it is being stored by the plant. All these simple sugar units called glucose, they join together, they combine together and form bigger units of sugar called starch. Now let us discuss starch test. Starch test is done basically to check the presence of starch in various substances. It is done with the help of iodine solution. In general, normally, the color of iodine solution is orange-brown. It can be more on the brownish side, it can be dark brown, or it can be yellowish also in color, depending on the concentration of the iodine solution. When this iodine solution, it reacts with the starch, the color of iodine changes to blue-black. Otherwise, the normal color of the iodine is orange-brown. When it reacts with starch, this color changes to blue-black. So, with the help of starch test, we are able to check the presence of starch. Before that, we have to understand the process of bleaching. The process of removing green color of the leaf by boiling it first in water and then in alcohol is called bleaching. See, in general, the meaning of bleaching is to remove something's color. You might have also heard that your mother is going to bleach the clothes. That means she is going to remove the color. So in the process of bleaching, we are removing the green color of the leaf and we are going to do it first by boiling it in water and then in alcohol. Now let us understand the starch test with the help of this diagram. See, first we take a green leaf and we put it in boiling water. We boil it for some time in the water. After that, we take it and we put it in the alcohol and we boil it in the alcohol. Please pay attention that this ethanol which is there in the diagram, this is a form of alcohol. Alcohol is never being heated directly on fire, otherwise it will catch fire and start burning itself. It can be very dangerous. So we use water bath to heat the alcohol or to boil the alcohol. What we do is we take a vessel in which water is there, and then inside a test tube we take some alcohol. In that alcohol we put the leaf, and then this test tube which is containing the leaf and alcohol is being put inside boiling water, so that indirectly the alcohol and the leaf are boiling. After boiling the leaf in the alcohol, we take it and we put it in the cold water for some time so that it does not get dry and break. Here the process of bleaching of the leaf is complete. Now we take this bleached leaf in a small tray, a plate or a petri dish, and with the help of a dropper, we put some drops of iodine solution on this leaf. Wherever the presence of starch is there, the color of iodine changes to blue-black. This is what is going to happen when we will put iodine solution on top of this leaf. The color of the leaf will turn blue-black. Now, after this slide, there are a few videos which are showing various types of starch tests. Please go through them and we will meet after that.
Hello, my name is Dennis, and today I'm going to show you how to test for starch in common household products. And to do this, we're going to use iodine. And today we're going to be using tincture iodine, which you can purchase at your local pharmacy. So we have an apple and a potato here. So first thing we're going to do is scoop out a little piece of each. Apple. So what we do is we just take some of the iodine solution, and this is what iodine looks like when it's just in a beaker. So we'll put a couple drops on the apple, and then we put a couple drops on the potato. So as you can see, the potato turns into a very dark blue or a black color, and the apple piece just kind of held the reddish tint color to it that iodine naturally has. So the potato contains starches where the apple does not, and that is why it turned into a dark black color.
Do you know that leaves of plants produce glucose through photosynthesis? The excess glucose is then converted into starch, which is the reserved food material in plants. Let us do a small experiment to test the presence of starch in leaves. We need a leaf, boiling water, alcohol, iodine solution, test tube, spirit lamp. Take a leaf from a plant that has been exposed to sunlight for several hours. Place the leaf in boiling water. This will kill the leaf, disrupt the cell membrane, and soften the cell walls, allowing the iodine to enter the cells and react. Now put the leaf in a test tube and cover it with alcohol. Keep the test tube in the boiling water. The chlorophyll slowly dissolves into the alcohol. Note that alcohol turns green. Removal of chlorophyll will help us observe the color change of iodine clearly. Place the bleached leaf in a petri dish. pour iodine solution over it. Note the color of the leaf. It changes to dark green. This is because iodine combines with starch present in the leaf and forms a violet-colored complex. This shows that starch is present in leaves. Now cover a leaf with a black paper for a couple of days and do the same test. See if it still has starch.
Take a potted plant with wide leaves. Keep it in a dark place for weekdays. In these weekdays, photosynthesis does not take place in the plant due to unavailability of sunlight. Hence, the starch which is present in leaves consumed by the plant. Now, leaves are free from starch. Then select a leaf and cover half of the leaf with a piece of black paper by using a clip. Keep the entire setup in sunlight for 4 to 5 hours. Here, the part of the leaf does not expose to the sunlight, which is covered by the black chart. Detach the leaf from plant. Remove the clip and chart from the leaf. Boil the leaf in methylated spirit over a water bath till it becomes pale white. Then test the leaf by using iodine solution. Part of the leaf which is exposed to sunlight turns into blue-black color. It indicates that photosynthesis takes place in this part. Part of the leaf which does not expose to sunlight doesn't turn into blue-black color. It indicates that photosynthesis does not take place in this part. So,
Welcome back, students. I'm sure you enjoyed the videos. Now let us discuss what happened in those videos. In the first video, the starch test was being performed on apple and potato. Since potato is a pure source of starch, the iodine solution when being put on it turned to blue-black immediately. However, in case of apple, it does not contain the starch, so the color of the iodine did not change. In the second test, the starch test was being performed on a normal green leaf, and you must have seen that the color of the leaf changed to blue-black immediately after putting the iodine solution. In the third video, the starch test was being performed on a plant which was being kept in dark for a few days, and after that, when the plant was being brought back in the sunlight, a part of the leaf was covered with black paper so that it does not get sunlight. And when the starch test was being performed on the leaf, it was seen that the part covered by the black paper and the part which did not receive the sunlight was not able to turn the color of iodine solution into blue-black. This shows that the presence of sunlight is a necessity. It is very essential for the process of photosynthesis. Without sunlight, the process of photosynthesis cannot take place. In the last video, you saw that the starch test was being performed on a variegated leaf. This leaf had green color in some parts and other parts did not have green color. It was white in color. And we remember that the green color of the plant is there because of the presence of chlorophyll. Without chlorophyll, the plants cannot produce food, that is starch. So when the iodine test was being performed on this leaf, the part of the leaf which was green in color, that was able to turn the iodine solution into blue-black, but the part of the leaf which was not green, which was white in color, was not able to change the color of the iodine solution. This is proving, or this is telling us, that chlorophyll is a necessity for photosynthesis. Without the presence of chlorophyll also, the process of photosynthesis cannot take place. I hope you were able to understand the chapter and you will remember what is photosynthesis, what all things are required for photosynthesis, and what is the requirement of leaves, how plants make their food, how they store it, how it is being used, why plants are important for us, and also the starch test performed to test the presence of starch in various parts of the leaf. Please stay safe, stay inside your home. Follow the rules being told by your parents and the government. Stay safe, stay healthy, and I will meet you again for the next chapter. Thank you.